Now, I've been quite fortunate to be noticed by a few small developers, which is pretty awesome, and I love actually hearing from them, because every once in a while I'll cover a game and they'll be like, oh, hey, I saw your video on the game and I thought that was awesome. It hasn't happened recently, because I haven't been checking out a lot of smaller indie games, but one developer contacted me on Twitter and he's like, hey, I saw your videos, I thought your feedback style was really good, and so could you end up checking out my game? So this is Solaroids Prologue, or I think it's Prologue, or is that just the early access name? I don't know. Anyways, Michael here, and today we're going to be checking out Solaroids, which the developer ended up sending me a review key for this one. And so basically he's like, yeah, I want you to check it out and see what it's like. So he's in early access right now, and the game is in early access, so there's going to be a lot of stuff that's incomplete. I'm not going to try out the campaign because I have a feeling, just like most early access stuff, this is going to be the most incomplete portion of the game. I could be wrong, but there is a beta branch, and so this is the beta branch version of the game on whatever day it is. I forgot what day it is. It's like November or something like that. But anyways, we're going to end up checking it out, and I did change the style of my checking out series, but we're going to go ahead and do the style I was doing before, to where I'm just literally going to play blind. I'm assuming this is a style like Asteroids. I don't know what is anything about it, but I have no idea what's going on right now. So I guess there's multiple players, so you can actually have multiple players, which is kind of cool. But I'm just going to do free play and actually see what the game is about. So I know it's like Asteroids or something like that, and I'm going to play around with the controls for a bit. So A is to shoot, X is to that. That's a bomb. Oh, it actually shows the buttons on the screen. I'm an idiot. The UI is a little bit small for my current positioning, but yeah, I am terrible at Asteroids, by the way, and so this is probably going to go pretty bad. It seems like we actually have a forward thrust and then we have a back thrust. I would love to see some sort of side thrust, but I also know that that's not how these styles of games work. I'm more used to like the sort of, I don't know what they're called. I don't remember any of those games. I'm just blowing things up now because I don't know what I'm supposed to be doing, but I collected some points and it does seem sort of zoomed in. Like, I can't see very far. But there is a repair thing. Where is my health? I guess, do I have circles or something like that for health? I'm just running into things to see if I can see a health bar. I think our ship just kind of gets blown up, but now I lost all my abilities and stuff like that. So I guess we started off with some actual extra power, which is a little bit, I don't know, not explained. It is early access, and so basically I'm not expecting a lot from the explanation, but at the same time, I would like a tutorial. Maybe the campaign has a tutorial. Maybe we should try that first. But anyways, yeah, it seems like Asteroids. I'm not 100% sure what I think yet so far, but we do go from the top of the screen to the bottom of the screen. One thing that would be really nice is if we didn't have that sort of scroll. Oh, hey, I got a spread shot. Oh, it actually, that circle and stuff like that is showing like red, whatchamacallit. So like, what the hell? Okay. Yeah, so one thing about the top and bottom scrolling up here is like, if I go to the edge of the screen or whatever, you notice that it kind of goes off and then all of a sudden I teleport at the bottom. One thing in Asteroids that was actually quite genius about it is that you could do that. You can go from the top to the bottom, but you actually had everything on one screen, and so it was very easy to like see where you were going to end up and what you were going to end up running into and stuff. And I thought that was very, very fluid in that design. So basically what you would probably want to do is make it so that instead of just having it so that you hit the end of the screen, it just continues on, and then people would notice that you cycle over. Also, I died, so that's a thing. I'm just going to continue. I'm not very good at these styles of games either, and so basically when it comes down to difficulty and stuff like that, I'm not going to leave any sort of comments. Like, I'm going to find it really difficult, but that's because I'm terrible at these styles of games, and so maybe I'm not the best person to ask for feedback for that, but at the same time, you know, that's just how it is. So if you're wondering how a casual player would do, terrible. I'll just tell you that right now. It's just absolutely terrible because I was never good at Asteroids. I was never good at any of those styles of games. I was good at bullet hells. I was really, really good at bullet hells, but there's something about this control style specifically. Also, these missiles, having them homing and stuff like that is a little bit cheap in my opinion. But once again, that could just be because I'm terrible at it. I don't know. It's all right so far. I think that screen thing is really bothering me though, to where it's just like all of a sudden you fly off onto the side of the screen. You have no idea what you're going to end up running into next. I think that is really jarring and very not something you want. I think it would be very much better. I'm gonna use like the worst words in my vocabulary just because he asked for feedback on this. I'm going to use like the worst words just because I can. But yeah, having it so that it would basically just continue without having to have it so they just cut off on the screen like that and just have you teleport would be much better than having the current system. And maybe that's just because it's an early access. Maybe you're trying to figure out how to do that. That would be great if you could. But yeah, also, there was a giant beep and I have no idea what that means. Also, what is the image in the top left? Is that supposed to be like my Steam image or something? Does that have images of dogs on it or something? I think it was supposed to be cracks. I'm also not a fan of the art style so far. There are missiles freaking everywhere. Like, this is chaos. I assume I'm supposed to be following like the red circles and things like that, but it's very hard to see on those little tiny, like on that little tiny circle in the center, exactly what is where. Maybe making that circle a little bit bigger, or making an option so that you can make it bigger or something like that, or maybe a button. Maybe there is a button somewhere. Well, I blew that thing up. What is these 5Ks? Oh, I guess those are score. Okay, so I want to be picking those up for score, and then I could use bombs as well, which the bomb really doesn't seem to be doing much, so I guess that's not something that's going to help me very much. But I want to be grabbing these repair things, I assume is what they are. I will say that it's, I think it's pretty easy to actually see what the little power-ups are, because the icons are pretty easy to get once you actually see them. I could continue. Continue! It resets my score. I do like in free play that I can just keep going. That's kind of nice. I can just keep on playing, but I would like it to like hard reset when I actually retry, because now every time I spawn, I just have all this chaos to deal with. Am I spawning? There I go. Also, I don't know what that circle at the bottom is. I have no clue what that is or what it does. And so, is that my bomb meter? No, my bomb meter's up there, and I have missiles. Oh, do I have limited ammo in my A? I do. Oh, okay, so I just have limited ammo in general if I actually get a different weapon. I think the default weapon is probably infinite, just based off of game design. Can I blow that up? No, but I can run into it and then blow it up. Ha! My answer was yes. There we go. Not 100% clear on when you're going to spawn either. It seems like there's a lot of clarity problems I'm having with the game, which could just be me. But at the same time, you know, once again, you want to make sure that everyone knows exactly what's going on. I think a tutorial would help with that. I will say I'm not a fan of the art style, though. Not a fan of that. I think it's too basic, but at the same time, that's going to be mostly personal opinion. Like I said, I don't think it's too hard to read. I'm going to go ahead and... Oh, hey, look, controls. Wow. I found it. By the way, he did leave me a message on the controls and things that might be missing. However, it was like quite a while ago that he sent me that. So there's secondary defensive thrusters, reverse thrusters. Okay, so I did find everything. How do I go back? Oh, I just push back. Okay, forfeit. Right. Exit. There we go. You know what? Let's try the campaign. Let's do it. Level 1. Oh, so this is going to be like set levels, and then free play is just infinite mode, I assume. So maybe this will reset when I actually end up dying? Okay, so yeah, our base weapon actually is infinite. So maybe this will be a little bit more designed. I think I would like that a lot better if it was a little bit more designed and oriented around like a specific sort of playstyle. This is much easier for me to like get the hang of, because it's like, hey, you can forfeit the match and leave immediately. Okay, so there's the tutorial stuff I was missing. Maybe I should just start it off with the campaign immediately. That would have been smart. Okay, so what is the red? See, this is much better. This is much easier to kind of figure out. Oh, well, I went to the bottom of the screen. I don't know what the red is supposed to mean. Oops, I blew up. Like I said, I'm terrible at these. So here's the tutorial bit. So I guess like if you were to like pick up this game now, you'd probably want to go into the beta branch and try the campaign just to like get what's going on. I still don't know what those red dots mean, but now we're going to go towards a green circle. Is that going to be a collectible or something? Oh, well, now it's behind us, or now it's gone? Nope. I'm confused. Oh, there it is. Okay. So maybe it's just not 100% pointing towards it. I don't know. Maybe I just went by and didn't pay attention. Whoa! I'm starting to get the control of this. Control. Starting to figure it out. There we go. Grab over some tip. When you lose a ship, you can collect power-ups to detach and float. Increase your score commence with difficulty. Sweet. So the more difficult it is, the more points you get. That's a good way to reward difficulty. You could also throw in more enemies and add in more point multipliers. Increase your score commensurate with difficulty? That's a word I have never seen before. All right, I'm good at English. That's fine. I'm just running straight into asteroids. I am terrible at this. What is my health meter? Oh, is that at the bottom? Is that my health meter? Hold on, if I run into something. No, that is not my health meter, but I do start to like spark and stuff like that when I run into things. Where is my health meter? Or is it just like a number of hits? Like if I look at the top left, I just have one ship. Does that mean I have one hit left? No, does not mean I have one hit left. Or maybe it just didn't count. I don't know what actually shows your health on this game. I guess you don't have a health bar. Also, I think down at the bottom is... I don't know what that is. I'm trying to figure out what that circle is at the bottom, and I still don't know. Now there's beeping. That is fairly annoying. Meh. Okay. So what did that do? Did that tell me like there's a boss on the stage? Now I blew up. I have zero ships left. I'm curious if this is going to restart when I actually run out of lives. I actually like it when games like this actually have like set design levels. And so if you actually get like set design levels in this, I think that would be pretty cool. Although this isn't my style of game, so not necessarily going to like enjoy it 100%. Also, that power up disappeared. What a jerk. There we go. Okay, so I'm going to go towards the yellow circle. I think the yellow circle is an objective of some sort. I think red is supposed to be enemies, and I think what I didn't realize is that when the enemies are on screen, they disappear from the circle. And so I'm sort of noticing some of these sort of mechanics. They're just not 100% clear. So I just use a continue. And so no, it doesn't actually reset everything, but it does reset your score. And so basically having a penalty just be like score and stuff like that, I think that's fine as well. I would like to see an option for maybe a hardcore mode or something like that to where when you run out of lives, it would actually just say you're done sort of thing. I think that would be a good thing. That way you could actually have a hard reset and have it so that you can be like, oh, hey, I want to challenge myself and see if I can do this without, you know, failing. Also, I keep trying to use the left thrusters, or not the left thrusters, the left thumbstick, which is the front thrusters, to try and slow down. Maybe make an option to where one is slow down, one speed up, because I think that makes more sense for certain casual players, like players that are not good at asteroid style games, would probably find that much easier to get a control of. I know that may not be part of your design goals and things like that, and so maybe you want it to be a little bit more, you know, targeted towards people that liked asteroids. And so, yeah, I don't really know what that genre really offers either, and so I can't compare it to other styles of games. I will just say that this one so far, it's all right. I mean, I'm not having a bad time. I'm enjoying it, so that's good. Also, will this circle just, like, go to the other side? Okay, so the circle shows it on the closest side. So if we are at the edge of the screen, but it's going to be closer if we just go through the edge of the screen, it'll actually just switch to the other side. So perhaps on that one, because I have seen certain games that have this sort of edge reset and then it just bases it off of basically where the screen is or whatever. And so when you actually teleport to the other side, it moves the circle, which in this sort of scenario might make a little bit more sense because you do teleport once you go through that. But at the same time, you know, that might be something you're trying to fix in the future. I really think that you should. I think that, you know, removing that whole, you're just all of a sudden on the other side of the screen, you know, I think that really is jarring. Like, it's super, super jarring and not necessarily enjoyable. It makes it so that I want to avoid the sides of the screen when in reality, I should be like wanting to go to the edge of the screen just so I can find that next objective. Yay! I repaired my ship and then immediately ran into an asteroid. I'd be great at Star Trek. Nyarl. I'm going to blow up this enemy here. I don't really know what we're going for. Are we still on level 1? Is that like what we're going on right now? Am I just like absolutely terrible at this game? Which is perfectly possible. I'm not seeing very much weapon variety. I've seen like 3 weapons so far, but that could be just because I'm not getting very far. I still have no idea what the hell that circle is at the bottom. I'm going to assume that's something to do with score multipliers or something. Maybe it's something to do with enemies. I don't know. Maybe it is ship health and I'm just an idiot. I mean, it's probably ship health. Maybe it's ship health. Nope, it's definitely not ship health. I have confirmed that now. I have no idea what that circle is. I have absolutely no clue. Is there anything that actually shows... Oh, you can turn off camera shake. That's nice. Also, it supports a lot of resolutions, which is super, super nice. So I'm running at 1440 and it actually supports that. Super uncommon in indie games. It's super annoying. Miscellaneous? Nope. But you do have some extra options here if you wanted them. Yeah, I'm not seeing much of them that. Whatever. Not too big of a deal. Also, I am noticing some of the bullets disappear if I shoot too many of them. Or maybe it just has a range. Does it have a range? I think they just have a range. That makes sense. Oh, it's a timer until the boss shows up or something. Yeah. Does that mean we're on level 2 now? Is that what that is? Is it showing that we're on difficulty level 2? And that I'm absolutely terrible at this game? Also, how do I get rockets? I assume I have to get them from enemies or something like that. Oh, that's a bomb. Yeah, I have a bomb. I love bombs. Bombs are great. They explode. Turn agility increase. Increases maximum rotation speed. Oh, that's actually useful. I like that. I wish I could have more of those. Oh, one thing that would be really cool. I don't know, once again, if this goes towards your design goals or not. Being able to pick other ships. There was another asteroid-style score attack I played a long time ago called Bit Blaster XL. And that game actually had an interesting system where you could, like, pick your own ship or whatever. I am terrible at this game. But you could pick your own ship, and so they actually had different stats and stuff like that. So it made it so you could kind of customize your gameplay style. I think that would be interesting to see in one of these as well, since you are going for, like, having a campaign style thing and stuff like that, and having a story or something like that might be interesting, but I don't necessarily think it matters. If you're just going for, like, score attack, I think it would just be interesting just to have it as is. Also, I don't know if this happened by coincidence, but I think the high score on the top left is actually showing from my free play, I think? Unless that was 73,000, I'm not 100% sure. And yeah, that is level at the bottom, so basically it's showing, like, levels and things like that. So there we go. So I don't know, like, I think I've seen what I'm gonna get out of this. I mean, I'm not... So So to clarify, like, I'm not 100% a fan of these styles of games. I think they're fun for a little while, but I do get bored of them very, very quickly. It's not necessarily my... I mean, it's my genre. I love score attacks, but it's just, like, not my style of game. But that's a conclusion. I mean, it's all right so far. I mean, it's okay. It's early access, and so I would obviously, you know, recommend for people watching, like, you know, wait until it's, you know, out of early access and stuff like that. And I know early access is supposed to be like, oh, hey, they're going into early access so they can fund development of the game. But at the same time, you know, early access is very, you know, questionable. You never know if people are going to finish the game. I obviously have hopes for this developer, you know, because they did send me a key and everything like that. And so I just hope that they're a cool guy and everything. But at the same time, you know, it is early access, so keep in mind with that. But if what you see is, you know, interesting, make sure to give it a look. I think as a final conclusion for, like, my feedback and stuff like that, I'm not 100% fan of the art style, but that's mostly going to be on me. I think that, it, you know, it's sort of basic. I don't necessarily like that, you know, most of the attacks in the game, like the missiles and things like that, were automatically in homing attack. I think the free play kind of ramped up very, very quickly, which I'm sure a lot of people will like that if they're into Asteroids and things, because they'll be, you know, decent at these sorts of games. And I really like the pace of the campaign mode a lot better. I didn't realize the campaign mode was going to be like it is. So basically, it's kind of like, you know, you build up score and then you go into the next mode and things like that. And I think that's much better. And I think that, you know, allows for much more better designed gameplay. And so you could actually design these sort of enemies that you would run into and stuff like that. I think it needs more control options for, like, casual players and stuff like that if you really want to catch any sort of mass market or anything like that. Because the current control scheme, while it works for people that understand Asteroid games, it's also super complex for people that are terrible at them like me. And so being able to, like, have a thrust mode, maybe to where, you know, the right thrusters are just to accelerate and the other ones are to slow down, something like that, and then you just kind of, like, go towards it. I don't know, like, the programming kind of progress on a style like this. Like, I don't know how your physics are working. But as, like, an enjoyment factor, game's fun. I don't know. It's not terrible. I like it. It's all right. I mean, it's nice and fast-paced, and you're actually able to, like, go through and make everything fluid. I'm not seeing any obvious bugs or anything like that. Although that just did just randomly explode, but I think that was my shield. I don't know, that was a bit random. And, you know, obviously make it so that there's a tutorial or something. Maybe add in some variety to weapons and things like that. It would be interesting if there was different bomb types or things like that. You know, just having it so that there's just something to add in a little bit more variety. I know it's just a simple score attack game, and I don't know your scope, but yeah, just to throw out more ideas. But yeah, that's what I think about it so far. Thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. Also, sorry to the developer for taking so long. I also forgot your name, and so I'll have to look that up later on Twitter. I apologize. It took me a while to end up checking this one out because I just have a long list and I've been really busy lately. I've been working on my own game project recently, and so hopefully I'll be able to kind of throw in some of that eventually. But I'm working on not an Asteroids game. I'm actually working on a tactics game, and so that'll be interesting once I get around to it. But yeah, anyways, best of hope for your game and everything like that. It's not bad. And so, you know, I enjoy that. I was not expecting something bad. And so, you know, obviously I looked into this with a positive outlook. It's hopefully that hasn't jaded my opinion, but so far it looks all right. I haven't really played a lot of games in this genre. And so I don't think my perspective is going to be as in depth as other people. So definitely, like, if you're a viewer and you play a lot of Asteroid style games, or you've seen a lot of styles of games like this, you know, my experience is basically Bit Blaster XL. And that's the only game that I know of in this sort of subgenre. And so yeah, that and Asteroids, of course. So yeah, you know, obviously if you are viewing this and you have some feedback and stuff like that, make sure to jump over to their forums on the Steam and stuff like that. And I don't know if they have any other outlets. I know that they're on Steam, so end up checking them out on their link in the description. Anyways, thank you guys so much for watching, like I said, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Hopefully that was helpful. Probably not, but oh well.